Yes! Yes, yes, finally! Finally! Finally, Vasili Podkolzin has not one, but two KHL goals in two games. The Vancouver Canucks' 10th overall draft pick in the 2019 NHL Entry Draft is finally scoring goals! Finally, 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 finally. It's been a long time coming. And I know that this has been a very, very, very polarizing topic. And it pretty much has been ever since the draft back in June. The Vancouver Canucks took Vasili Podkolzin over some other guys that Canucks fans were probably interested in too. Cole Caulfield was available. Matthew Boldy was available. Peyton Krebs and Alex Newhook were available, but it's the Russian who was ranked third overall the entire year that the Vancouver Canucks take, and it is the Russian who was ranked third overall all of last year who is finally starting to get his fair share of KHL offensive action, and it comes at no better time. We've already talked about Podkolzin a few times this season, and it's actually kind of weird. Before we get into the actual goal scoring of Podkolzin, I wanted to talk about how different things have been for Podkolzin in comparison to our previous picks. When Elias Pettersson was drafted in 2017, I made a video pretty much every time he had a multi-point game, and every time he passed another legendary Swede in the rookie scoring charts. We made, I think, like 10 or 15 just Vekwa Lakers SHL Pettersson update videos in the 2017-18 season. That was my grade 12 senior year in high school. That's really when I started to become relevant on YouTube. And we made videos pretty much every few weeks about Pettersson. Oh, he's got a 5-point game. Oh, he's got a hat trick. Oh, he passed Henrik and Daniel. Oh, he passed Naslin. Oh, he passed Forsberg. Oh, he broke Kent Nielsen's rookie scoring record. 1 year after that, we talked about Quinn Hughes a lot. We made videos every time Quinn Hughes had multi-point games and all that. It was less frequent than the Pettersson stuff because Hughes obviously playing in the NCAA was a little bit different. The scoring isn't as high for rookie defensemen, or excuse me, for sophomore defensemen in the NCAA as they are for really gifted offensive Swedish forwards in the SHL, but we still talked about Quinn Hughes quite a bit last year. This year, though, we haven't really been doing anything Podkolzin related. We talked about Podkolzin a lot during the offseason, talked about his killer instinct, we talk about the shock of drafting Podkolzin, and we talked about the potential, but we didn't really talk too much about the updates, and a lot of that does have to do with the fact that he wasn't scoring. But, as most Vancouver Canucks fans will point out, duh, he wasn't scoring. He was being played 2-3 minutes a night on a KHL team that was stacked in a bottom six role. So it makes sense as to why he wouldn't be scoring. We talked about when he was scoring at the World Juniors, he was a pretty good player back then. But his whole KHL season, just like the World Juniors, was riddled with scenarios where Podkolzin could have gotten points, but his teammates just kind of let him down. We saw a lot of really nice Podkolzin plays at the World Juniors, where he would set up his teammates like crazy, but they would fan on the shot, or the Swedish goalie on the other end would make a really good save, or something like that. And it's kind of been like that for the KHL too. But recently, Vasili Podkolzin has honestly been given the opportunities. In his past 5 or 6, 7, 8 games, Vasili Podkolzin has been getting 11 minutes of time on ice, 12 minutes of time on ice. Sometimes he drops over to 8, but he's hovering around that 11, 12-ish minute mark now. And it's all paid off, because 2 games ago, playing for his KHL club, the SKA St. Petersburg, Vasili Podkolzin finally scored his first KHL goal. It's a really nice play where the puck is chipped over to him on the right side, driving in towards the net, and he cuts in front, dekes out the goalie, and he scores a goal while falling down. It's really similar to that Elias Pettersson goal we saw at the World Juniors a few years ago, where Pettersson kind of deked the pants off of the Swedish D-man, cut in on the right side, cut across through the slot in the left side, shot the puck while he was falling down and scored. It was really similar, the goals that were scored there by Podkolzin and Petey, but Twitter exploded. All the Canucks fans were so happy to see Podkolzin finally get a goal, because we've been waiting for this for so long, for Vasili Podkolzin to finally find comfort in the KHL. And it finally comes here. He gets a goal doing Vasili Podkolzin things, driving to the net, 110% work ethic out there, always. That's been something that has been a staple of his game for the past few years. So seeing him get a goal like that, where he's driving to the net hard, like a bulldog pretty much, it's such a characteristic goal of Vasili Podkolzin. But his next goal that he scored in the very next game, putting himself up at two goals in two games played, kind of shows off some of the other aspects of Vasili Podkolzin's game. And it's a really nice one. He cuts into the middle with the puck. He's kind of fiddling around with it. Some defenders get their sticks on it, but Vasili Podkolzin gets a handle on it as he's cutting into the dangerous area and whips a shot right onto the net. It gets by the goalie, and Vasili Podkolzin has two goals in two games. Who knows? Maybe this is the start of Vasili Podkolzin's goal-scoring tear for SKA St. Petersburg. I don't want to say that's what's going to happen, but I don't want to say I doubt it either. But Podkolzin is starting to showcase a higher level of comfort and a higher level of competence in the KHL. The way Vasili Podkolzin plays is such a defined style. If you're a Vancouver Canucks fan and you've never seen Podkolzin play, think Antoine Roussel, but a little bit bigger, a little bit stronger, and a little bit harder on the puck. Yeah. That's kind of hard to do if you're comparing that guy to Antoine Roussel, who already is a fireball out there. Podkolzin is able to do that, and he's able to do it well. He skates pretty nice in a straight line, and overall, he's always using his body to shield the puck and try to beat other defenders to the puck. It's something that's really well defined in his game, and it's why a lot of scouts really saw the NHL projectability within Podkolzin's overall game. And we're seeing that. We've seen that this entire past calendar year, pretty much, that Podkolzin does indeed exhibit this super strong work ethic that is going to get his teammates rallying behind him, and it's going to make him a fan favorite and a locker room favorite. But the production that he was able to do at the Ivan Hlinka 2 years ago, and the overall level of success that he would have, wasn't translating to the pro leagues. Mostly because he wasn't being played all too much, and mostly because playing against men is a different kind of game than playing against other 18, 19-year-olds. So, in order for Podkolzin to really establish that comfort, I'm really happy that he's actually there in the KHL. The argument has been brought up, and we've said it on this channel before too, there's no discrepancy here. If you're frustrated that Podkolzin is going to spend 2 years in Russia developing, hey, at least that's better than these American guys who are spending 2, 3, 4 years in college before even playing pro hockey. Or some of these OHL guys who are just going to be playing 1 or 2 extra years of CHL hockey before even getting their pro taste of action. Podkolzin, at the very least, is already in a pro league, and he's already experiencing what it's like being a mainstay against men. Same with Nils Höglander, who has a completely different skill set than Podkolzin, but, you know, the circumstances in which they are playing actually are the same. Obviously, KHL is a little bit better than SHL, but the point still remains. SHL is indeed better than the OHL or the WHL. It's why I've always been saying that Podkolzin to me is a guaranteed NHL player at the very least. He will play in this league once his contract in the KHL expires. He will come over here and he will have an impact. It's just a question on whether or not that goal scoring and playmaking that he can possess translates as well. Because at the very least, even if Podkolzin doesn't put up any points, what we have is a guaranteed fireball, a Roussel but stronger, a Tyler Mott but stronger and harder on the puck and harder to knock off. What we have is a guaranteed player who can indeed make an impact, and the only question is whether or not that offensive production that we saw so greatly at the Ivan Hlinka a few years ago is going to translate too. Time will tell, But getting two goals in two KHL games to start off your goal scoring in this league, I think that's a pretty good sign. Hope you enjoyed this video. And bye.